sound, am I right? So we in the last video we have discussed about how we can produce the sound, how the sound is propagated, then what are the characteristics of the sound. Sound is a form of energy. Sound is nothing but it is in the which form? It is in the wave, am I right? We have learned the different terms related to the waves, yes or no? So in today's video we are going to start with the one important point, that is audible and inaudible sound. But before that, let's do one activity. Just move your hand for twice and thrice. Yes, just move and try to listen the motion of your hand. Can you hear some noise? Are you able to hear the noise? Come on, do it. Yes, you can hear. Now move it very rapidly. Are you able to hear the noise of your hand? No, we are not able to hear the noise of your hand. Just a 2 minutes. Do the activity once again. Yes, are you able to hear the noise of your hand? No, you are not able to hear the voice of your hand. Am I right? So, there are some sounds which the human being can hear, and there are some sounds that human being cannot hear. So, what are that? That we are going to see. That is audible and inaudible sound. Now, just listen. That there are the mainly three types of sound: ultrasonic, audible, and infrasonic. Okay, what is meant by the ultrasonic? Means the sound which we cannot hear, means the sound which is more than 20,000 hertz, more than 20,000 hertz that we are unable to hear. Are you getting? So that sound is called as a ultrasonic sound. That sound is called as a ultrasonic sound. For example, now see, in the medical, the machines which are there for the relief pain, means for example, you might have seen the different machines for checking the stomach, for the sonography, they are using the ultrasonic sound which is more than 20,000 hertz, which is more than 20,000 hertz, that we are unable to hear it. We don't have the capacity to hear that sound. And also the less sound, we are unable to hear it. Now when you were doing the activity, the sound was there, but we are unable to hear that sound. That sound means the sound was very less. The sound was very less. Now have you experienced the earthquake? Yes, it makes some sound. It makes some sound, but we are unable to hear it because that sound is very less than 20 hertz, that we are unable to hear it. We are unable to hear it. Now, the range of the human being means we can hear the sound up to 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. Are you getting? The human being can hear the sound. The range of between hearing the sound for the human being is 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. If the sound is more than 20,000 hertz, then that sound is called as a ultrasonic sound. That sound is called as a ultrasonic sound. And if the sound is less than 20 hertz, that sound is called as a infrasonic sound. That sound is called as a infrasonic sound. Less than. And it is more than 20,000 hertz. Are you getting this? Means the sound which is more than 20,000 hertz, that sound is called as ultrasonic, while the sound which is less than 20 hertz, that is called as a infrasonic. The human being can hear the sound between frequency 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. We can hear the sound 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. 3000 hertz. Now there are some certain animals such as dog, leopard, bat. They can hear the sound of ultrasonic sound. They can hear more than 20,000 hertz sound. Are you getting? Bat uses this ultrasonic sound to capture the prey. Are you getting? To means if the any obstacle is near to that particular pattern, they uses the ultrasonic sound. Are you getting? So there are some animals like dog, leopard, then also the dolphin. They uses the ultrasonic sound. These are some animals which can hear the ultrasonic sound, which is more than 20,000 hertz. Now, the range of the human being is to hear is 20 hertz. The range is 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. Now, infrasonic. Now, there are some things, for example, the earthquake, volcano, the sound is very low. Elephant, also the animals like whale, elephant, they can hear the less than 20,000 hertz sound, that is called as a infrasonic sound. That sound is called as a infrasonic sound. So in today's video we have discussed the three main types of the sound, that is ultrasonic, audible and infrasonic sound. Now can you just tell me what is meant by the ultrasonic? Means the sound which is more than 20,000 hertz, that is called as a ultrasonic sound. For example, dog, leopard, bat can hear the ultrasonic sound. Then also the dolphin can hear the ultrasonic sound. And audible sound, this sound is heard by the human being. Then infrasonic is the sound which is very less than 20 hertz, that sound is called as a infrasonic sound. For example, which of the animals can hear the infrasonic sound? Elephant, yes, whale, these are the animals. And the sound of earthquake, volcano eruption, simple pendulum, they have the infrasonic sound. I hope you have understood this video. Just make a list of the ultrasonic, audible and infrasonic. You can watch the video again and make the note on this video. Thank you everyone.